to welcome one of our distinguished alumna, Marion Jones. Marion is going to come forward and she's going to talk about her rise, her Olympic downfall, and her path for forgiveness and overcoming and finding success. Let us all give Marion a warm welcome.
Friends, former teammates, and now you got my horse all, my voice all hoarse from laughing and having a good time. It's funny when you get us together. It's just, I mean, it could be 1994. During my 4 years here, going to classes, forming relationships, training, competing, I learned how to succeed through pride, through leadership, perseverance, confidence, and teamwork. After graduating in 1997, I felt ready to take on the world, that I had been equipped with the tools to succeed at the highest level in life. And I did that in spectacular fashion for a while. When I first got the invitation to speak here tonight, I was surprised, I was excited, but those feelings soon gave way to, as I mentioned before, apprehension and caution. Because most, if not all of you, are aware of some version of the epic and highly publicized twists and turns and triumphs and failures of my personal and professional life in the decades since I left Carolina. And agreeing to be here not only meant that I would have to face you all with the confusion that I caused and disappointments, but I'd also have to face myself in all of this once again. I'll be honest with you, although I deeply value my relationships with several of you here, and Carolina Blues still runs deep in my veins and hopefully in the veins of my kids, if I have anything to do with it. Choosing to return here was not an altogether easy choice to make, but I'm here and I'm glad to finally be back on the right track. Before I really go any further, I wanted to take this opportunity to personally apologize to you, my friends. Go home. And once again, God had a different plan for me. And as opportunities came, he started showing me that by not putting myself back out there and sharing my life experiences and what I had learned because of fear, because of being embarrassed, because of maybe thinking that at some point I was burned along the way, I was not exercising true faith. So you see, fear and faith, it's very interesting. Fear and faith are enemies, and they always are fighting inside of us. And if we don't grab a hold of it, they can literally kill you. And at the end of the day, we decide which one will win in our lives. God, you begin to realize that it's my responsibility not to disappear, not to just go home and share this blessing with my kids and my husband. That I have to get out there, even if it takes having to confront my past, even if it takes me having to come back to Carolina and face everything. It's really my responsibility. It's not something, like I said, that I worked at. And despite what others may say or write about me, I'm responsible only to God for those blessings. I've been given a second chance, and thankfully the final chapter in my life is not even close to done. This time around, if I don't do what I'm supposed to do because of either shame or fear, then I'm not only being selfish, but I also have to answer to God. And I'll admit, it's not easy. You see me up here, and I look fairly comfortable, but let me tell you, it's not easy to have to talk about my mistakes in front of so many people. You know, when you guys make mistakes, most of you, you don't necessarily have to travel around the world and tell people about it constantly. You know, you deal with it in your own way. And so it is not easy for me to constantly do this, but I do it because I know that my story and my life experiences could possibly help people.